One of the most ironic things is that I'm a geneticist and I've actually never done a genetic test. I'm Dr. Janina Jeff, and this is The Word, about the complicated relationship between Black people and genetic ancestry testing. I became interested in science as a very young girl in New Orleans. I used to do science fairs, and then I started winning them. After I finished my college degree at Spelman College, I went on to Vanderbilt and did some rotations and knew that I wanted to be in human genetics. And so when I got to Vanderbilt, I got a PhD in human genetics. And fun fact, I'm the first African American to receive a PhD in human genetics from Vanderbilt. So I think we should start with what DNA is. And DNA is a molecule that is found in your genes. And so DNA consists of four letters, A, T, C, and G. And these four letters in certain combinations and sequence make up genes. Genes are like an instruction manual, and genes give your body all of the instructions that it needs to survive. And in addition to those, there's a small percentage that makes us different. So when one person might have an A, you may have a C at that location. And if you have a C at that location, you might have a different physical representation, or what we call a phenotype. So the four letters that I talked about, A, T, C, and G, they can change, and when they change, they're usually changing to help your body survive or to help a population survive. The first modern human evolved out of Africa. So because our genomes are the descendants of ancestors that were thousands and thousands of years ago, we have a lot of information in our genomes about how the body has evolved from generation to generation. Direct-to-consumer tests are any tests that any person can order without a physician. And some of the direct-to-consumer tests you might be familiar with is 23andMe, Ancestry.com, Family Tree DNA, MyHeritage DNA, African Ancestry, AfroRoots. So you send in your DNA and they compare your DNA with other DNA samples that they have in their database, something that we call a reference. And that reference might represent a common ancestor you may have, let's say in Africa or in Europe. Now, as you would imagine, if the database is limited in representation, what you get back is the next best match, which may or may not be an actual representation of your genome or your genetic ancestry. Companies are now increasingly updating their results. And that's a very positive thing. That means that they're working to improve their database and their methods so that you get accurate results. I like to tell everyone to not get too attached to the genetic ancestry results, as they're going to be dynamic, constantly changing, and we should be embracing all of our common ancestors and not try to just be tied to one story. One thing that's extremely disturbing to me is that a lot of these companies are marketing towards non-European populations, specifically African descended populations. And in some cases, they're marketing a fairy tale about our past.
Abigail, we can escape.
And they're not being very considerate of how a Black woman specifically might engage with her genetic ancestry test. We know the history of slavery. We know the history of our fair skin or that European ancestry that lives within us. And it's not a very positive thing. This is a result of rape most times. To market us in a way that this is a fairy tale, that having European ancestry is something positive, directly goes into white supremacy. While these companies are all well-intended and they want to do really positive things, transparency is a big key in getting African descendants to participate. Transparency around privacy, so how will my data be used? Will you give access to your database to the FBI or any other government official? I've gotten a free test years and years and years ago, and I learned that anything that's given away to you for free is not actually free. That means you're the product. And I don't think it's clear to a lot of people that you're paying to get your genetic results, but then they're selling your data. And I think a lot of people would feel a little differently about that. Do you want to sell your data? Do you feel like you should get a profit from the selling of your data? I want everyone to be their own shareholder of their DNA. There are a lot of things that have happened in research that have kind of caused this distrust in our community. One of the most famous is Henrietta Lacks. Henrietta Lacks was a Black woman who had cervical cancer, and she went in to get treated at Johns Hopkins Hospital, and the physician extracted cells from her and saw that these cells continued to replicate. What he did is he continued to use those cells in his cancer research, and her cells are being used in every present day research cell biology lab. Henrietta did not consent for the use of her cells to be used in research. Furthermore, there's a financial gain to being able to use those cells in these labs, and there is a lot of money that's being made. How is that money now trickling down to Henrietta and her family or the Black community at large? I like to believe, though, while a lot of research has been unethical, we do have power within our genome. We have to remember the control we have in sharing our data. And I don't ever say no one should take a genetic test. I actually feel quite the opposite. We all should be engaging in genomics research when we know everything about what can happen. And the more we start to learn about our genomes and embrace the value that is within our genomes, we might be able to use it as a tool for generational wealth. Since we know that value and since companies are using that value to sell that data, we might be able to do that on our own. I want to see that Black futures be prioritized. Talk to me about diseases and illnesses that are impacting Black people specifically, and I would be much more engaged to want to help, because really, if I can give my genome to a company and I know that their intentions are to help generations behind me, then I feel like I'm doing something good, not only for myself, but for the relatives that I might not ever meet. We should be marketing towards the way the genome holds promise to our futures.